Hi, it's Michael back today from KORONA POS to talk barcodes. Remember, streamlining and optimizing your inventory management is a necessity for even the smallest retailers. Some of you may not need more advanced features like stock transfers or store orders, but everyone needs basic counts and SKU and UPC management. Such inventory management wouldn't be possible without the barcode. This clever invention allows merchants to seamlessly track all products from the moment they enter your store until the point that they're paid for and go out your door. It's truly remarkable for both its simplicity and effectiveness. But there's a bit more to them than initially meets the eye. Barcodes differ from SKUs and UPCs, and there are various types of barcodes. Plus, there are some pretty cool benefits of barcodes that you may not have realized. We put together this FAQ video to help you navigate barcodes and how you can implement them effectively at your store. So what is a barcode? The barcode was invented in 1951 by Norman Joseph Woodland and Bernard Silver. Their inspiration came from Morse code, extending dots and dashes into thick and thin bars. Despite not achieving much commercial success for several decades after its invention, the structure and function of the barcode has remained relatively unchanged. It still features an array of black lines of varying degrees of thickness. These are accompanied by a set of numbers below them. Barcodes began to be used commercially in the early 1970s after George Lohrer altered the original circular design to be horizontal and thus more easily read by a scanner. The series of parallel black lines separated by white could be easily scanned to facilitate the checkout process or inventory management operations. And in 1974, a pack of chewing gum became the first product ever scanned with a UPC code. The technology has evolved to QR codes and automatic identification and data capture, though these systems also maintain the simplicity that made the barcode such a success. But how do barcodes work in practice? Well, each barcode has a unique combination of lines. Any given combination encodes certain information about a product. This information can then be translated into actual text that appears on a digital screen. Additionally, this information is sent to a POS device that can attach further information once it's scanned. For instance, the barcode might contain the product name, but once scanned, the POS machine pulls up the pricing, description, matrix, and more. This relatively simple technology brings a whole lot of benefits with it. Barcodes are a critical tool for nearly every retail business. Aside from facilitating transactions, there are several other key benefits that they do offer. First and foremost, barcodes make inventory management much, much easier. Combine the scanning technology with your POS and reporting systems, and you'll get significant insight into your products and how they're each performing. They also offer more accuracy. With barcode scanners, there's a lot less room for small clerical errors. And with improved accuracy, you'll also improve your ordering, costing, pricing, promotions, and losses. Plus, overall, implementing a system of barcodes is remarkably easy, especially compared to some of the other projects the average business owner has to deal with. Data migration takes minutes, and creating new UPCs and SKUs in your point of sale is straightforward and can be done in bulk. You also get more insight into your business with real-time data. As soon as a barcode is scanned into your inventory or as a sale is made, that change is reflected in the back end of the system. This notifies you when stock is low, connects to other sales channels so you don't sell something you don't have in stock, and it even communicates with suppliers for automated reordering. Additionally, it's an investment that won't be antiquated anytime soon. There's a reason barcodes have hardly changed in 50 years. They work. And even though the technology has evolved in more recent years to add QR codes and SKUs, the root of it and the associated hardware haven't really changed. It's an investment that will last. Barcodes also help businesses scale. Businesses can easily expand their operation to multiple locations or franchises with ease. All barcode data can be transferred to a new location, minimizing the time and cost of growing your business. And finally, it saves time, lowering your overhead costs. There is no longer a need for a full-time inventory manager or stock person. Plus, it automates several other processes, saving you more time and money. Now, how is a barcode programmed and processed? In order to process a barcode, it needs to be scanned. Scanners come in many shapes and sizes, but their job is to read the barcode information and transport it to the appropriate system. Scanners help retailers maintain great efficiency and accuracy by creating a seamless channel for data entry into their POS software. For retailers, this means sending the barcode information to the point of sale system. The vast majority of merchants will use one or multiple of three types of scanners. First and most simply are 1D scanners or one-dimensional scanners. These scanners read simple barcodes on flat surfaces. The scanners process less information since the codes get physically longer as more information is added. Most 1D scanners are the handheld gun model. These must be pointed directly at the barcode and usually don't come with omnidirectional scanning capabilities. The normal range is up to 2 feet. Alternatively, you have 2D scanners or two-dimensional scanners. These hold a lot more information than 1D. In fact, they can hold up to 2,000 characters, yet be physically smaller than a barcode. This is because 2D codes add squares, hexagons, dots, and other patterns instead of just lines. Additionally, 2D scanners can process QR codes, so retailers can use these to scan smartphone screens, activate loyalty check-ins, upload images, connect to URLs, pull up menus, play video recordings, and more. These scanners come in many different models, but each can scan omnidirectionally, helping to facilitate a smoother checkout experience. Finally, either scanner can also pick up alphanumeric codes for SKUs. Not every retailer will need them to do this, but bigger operations that need more product segmentation will benefit from creating alphanumeric SKUs in addition to the standard UPCs. But now you're probably wondering what a UPC is. Short for Universal Product Code, a UPC is an identifying code printed on retail items. It consists of the black bars that can be scanned, as well as a 12-digit numeric code underneath. UPCs, as the name suggests, are universal across all retailers. It was created to simplify and speed up the ordering, inventory, and checkout process. The first 6 digits of a UPC are used to identify the individual manufacturer. Every product from a certain manufacturer will therefore have the same first 6 digits. The next 5 digits are used to identify the individual product. Each unique size, color, shape, etc. will get its own 5 digits. Finally, the last digit is used to check the authenticity of the entire code and make sure that the item rings up correctly at the checkout. This is often referred to as the check digit. Additionally, you might see a difference in UPC sizes. While the 12-digit code is standard, there is a shortened version of the code that some retailers use to simplify their inventory process. UPC A refers to the standard length code. The alternative code, or UPC E, is shortened by compressing unused zeros at the end of the manufacturer code or the beginning of the product code. Any manufacturer must apply with the Global Standards Organization to obtain a new UPC. But what, you may ask, now is the difference between a UPC and a SKU? Most importantly, a UPC is universal across all retail locations, while a SKU is only used internally within a single company. So a product that's sold by multiple businesses will only have one UPC, but multiple SKUs. SKUs are used to help businesses track inventory. They're alphanumeric codes that can be printed on a unique label or one attached to a UPC. SKUs are not necessary for every retailer. Only those that need more in-depth product reporting will benefit from creating SKUs. Think of it as a supplement to UPCs. Now, for more information on how to implement UPCs and SKUs through your point-of-sale software, click the link in the description. KORONA POS has the best retail inventory management on the market. With a free trial, we'll upload your existing product line into your account so you can see exactly how your existing SKUs and UPCs will work. Thanks for checking us out, and don't forget to subscribe to our blog and channel.